guys, it's Ayaz No Tomato here, and welcome back to Ayaz No Tomato Speed Draws, I guess. It used to be just called Ayaz No Tomato Draws, but because that's the name of the channel now, I guess it's called just the Speed Drawing Series. I don't know. For those of you who don't know, or just never saw, on the Ayaz No Tomato TF2 back in the day, like last year, I made speed drawing videos, which just supposed to be nice, chill kind of series where I just draw a picture in the background, speed it up, and give some nice, just unedited commentary over it. Just kind of talk about my process, what I'm drawing, the subject matter, whatever have you, and and like there was a long running series. I had like 10, 13 episodes. I can't remember exactly how many episodes on there. I'll make a playlist for this channel as well. And it's just continuing on here. So yeah. And that's basically the gist of it. So I suppose I'll jump right into the subject matter here, where I am drawing Made in Abyss. Now, I absolutely flipping gosh dang diddly doodah love Made in Abyss. All right, I love it. I love it. A lot. I've watched the entire series twice, and I'm now reading the manga, or manga, whatever it's, look, I don't know. And, holy dooly, it's changed my life. It hasn't changed my life, but, well, maybe a little bit, I don't know. It's so inspiring to me, and the stories are so fascinating to me, and it's encouraging me for my writing and art and ideas and stuff like that. And it's just one of those things where it's like, I wish I could recommend it to everyone. I don't know if I can do that, because there are certain parts about this show which, if you've seen it, you're probably thinking, yeah, the Japanese culture and their stance on how they treat younger children characters is, iffy when it comes to ethicalness. I won't go into details about it, but, it's one of those situations where you kind of got to prepare yourself, or desensitize yourself or something, just for what you're going to get in for. Not to mention, this show is also incredibly dark, which is, as you might notice, an elephant in the room, I suppose, which is, hey, Ayaz No Tomato, why are you drawing this scene? Of all the scenes, why are you drawing this one? one of the, inarguably, I suppose, more darker scenes of the show, without, if you haven't seen it, I won't spoil it, but it's a, you can probably just tell by what's happening in this scene, it's not exactly nice. There's a reason for it, alright? It's a terrible reason, and you might hate me for it, but there is a reason, and I only ask that you stay with me till the end, and I'll tell you why, alright? I'll tell you one reason, actually. I love Bondrude. I love his design, and his character is fascinating. He's an asshole, of course. He's straight up pretty much evil, but he's a fascinating villain, I'll tell you what. There's, such interesting characters in this show, I tell you. I can't gush about it enough, because that's essentially what this whole series is, isn't it? It's just me talking about, it's just gushing about all of the things that I draw. I draw stuff that I like. I will talk about the process as well, of course. It's something that I kind of forget to do. It's just the thing is, it goes by so fast, and I think I might have forgotten to mention, this drawing took about, it took 7 hours and 41 minutes all up. And I narrowed it down to possibly more than 7 hours and 30 minutes, just because I cut out my breaks and stuff like that. So it was a decently long drawing. I think the longest I've drawn in this series so far. I don't actually know. I just straight up don't know. The thing is that I have done drawings that take way longer, such as every single page of Cast the Psychopath, my webcomic. They often round about 10 hours or so. But yes, so one thing about this drawing is Bondrude himself, which is the guy I'm drawing right now, if you don't know. He is incredibly difficult to find references for, official references, because all of his drawings, all of his references and stuff are always covered in shadow or all sketchy. It's oftentimes covered in shadow, I should say. He's always in the dark, and his clothes are all dark, and he's really, really difficult to figure out what he looks like. So you might notice there on the side that I don't have official artwork. I do have a piece of official artwork I think I bring in later, but I actually have other people's fan art just so I can use them as reference. I'm not going to claim that they're mine or anything like that. I'm just using them so I can get an idea of what the hell this guy looks like. But what's even funnier than that, you might notice that these two pieces of fan art are already different in their own. And I discovered that it's actually because, to make matters even more confusing, Bondrude actually wears two different, pairs of clothing. Two different suits, I guess. You know, they're very, very slightly different, and unless you're drawing him like me, you probably wouldn't notice, but yeah, he does. And it's minor differences, but enough to make you go, oh, what the hell am I drawing? I think I'm actually drawing like a weird amalgamation of the two, because I just couldn't. By the time I figured out that there even was, he even had two different suits, I was just like already halfway through this, and I'm like, I can't be bothered. And him drawing Nanachi as well, which, you know, like, there's still references for, but it's a little bit difficult. And then after this, of course, I drew Mitty. And Mitty also has not as many references. Like, I had to go through the show itself to get some of these screenshots later on, because this whole scene is all very, very dark, and it's kind of difficult to figure out exactly what's going on. And I try different lighting and stuff like that. Which is something, actually, I wanted to say as well, is that I'm really excited for the speed drawing. I've been really, really looking forward to just getting back into this series, because the last, 2 months, like I said, I've just been working on all these videos that I haven't actually had much time to just sit down and draw a drawing, you know? I actually did do one, a month ago or so, of a random character who is dead in my comic series. I just drew that character, just fully, just colored and everything. And the reason I did that was just because, I just want to draw something, man. I just want to, just draw nothing. Something that means nothing, you know, in the long scheme of things. Because everything I've been working on recently has just been, it's all part of this big thing. Launching the channel and all these big videos and the Patreon and all that kind of stuff. And I just wanted to draw something that just was, just a thing, you know? And it just stands on its own thing. Also, you might notice that I'm having a nightmare with this foot here. I've redrawn it, 15 million times. But I think I finally got something I was happy with. It's really difficult to do that perspective of feet. Feet have always been my most difficult thing to draw, because I don't even know why. I'm pretty good at them now, I think, but certain angles and stuff, they get me, you know. Also, you might notice that I'm drawing hands a bit differently to what I normally do as well. Just a little bit. I'm trying, particularly with Bondrude, I was trying to give him a bit of a floppy vibe, a cartoon, maybe Disney or Warner Brothers character that's, you know, kind of flopping around, bouncy kind of vibe. A little bit. I don't know. I'm doing hybrids. I'm doing experimentation, I guess. I think that's a big thing about this series as well, actually. It's just me experimenting and making, you know, just what I want to make. Just random stuff. Just having fun, you know. Now, I mentioned Cass earlier. Cass the Psychopath, again, that's my comic series. I forget what I've said because this is, unfortunately, the second time that I've had to record this, because I get interrupted a fair amount in this little house of mine, but because I have to share it with two other people and two dogs, so it's difficult to get the 15 minutes required to just talk. Anyway, what's this thing? Oh yeah, I wanted to ask you guys a bit of a question. Now, the thing about this series is sort of okay. This is the new series. I'm bringing this through from the Eyes No Tomato TF2 channel, right? So it's sort of a new series here. But I actually had an idea for another new series, because this is more of a continuation more than anything than a new series. And that idea was to make a thing called the long draw, right? And what the long draw is that I would draw maybe a drawing like this, or actually specifically a page for my comic, which, you know, that usually takes me around 10 hours or something. And maybe I'll just, I don't know, it's kind of iffy, because what basically the idea is that I find that I really enjoy having something in the background while I draw, you know. Even while I was drawing this, I was listening to a ton of podcasts and stuff, because I can't describe it. I can't just sit there and draw. I like to listen to something and keep my mind on two things at once, because the thing is that I like drawing so much, and it's such second nature to me that I can just draw and not think about it, but still kind of split my mind. Either way, if you're a creator of any kind, that you probably know that you like having something on in the background, you know. I know of people who put on whole movies in the background to listen to. But anyway, I like the idea of making something like that, as well, you know? And because I've found the number one thing that I enjoy listening to the most while I'm drawing is actually other people drawing, you know, and talking about their creative process and stuff like that. Also, sorry if you can hear someone in the background. Again, I live in a small house and I have very limited time to record. But I'm trying to keep focused. Despite them moving a table now, apparently. Okay, yeah, that's right, not like I'm recording. All right, so yeah, I had an idea called the long draw where I would make something along this line of like a speed drawing kind of thing, except longer, you know, it's like maybe an hour or two. Maybe I'll just draw a drawing that takes an hour or two and it's not sped up at all and it's live commentary, so I can actually talk about my thought process as I go along, because it's kind of difficult to go over 8 hours of thought processes in a 15 minute video, I'm not gonna lie. Like, here, what am I thinking about here? Like, oh yeah, I was trying to get all these different references and realized that for this scene they had two different lighting styles, so I'm going with one particularly and it kind of looks weird, but like, it's when I add in the shading it actually will look good, because she just looks completely blue right now, but you'll see when I add in the shading it kind of starts to pop a bit better. And then when I add in the rest of the background, it all works and melds and meshes together much better. Anyway. But yeah, so I had this idea for maybe a long draw thing where I just, you know, just like, it's sort of like a podcast, sort of like a, just, I don't know, a big thing. So if you guys are interested in that at all, maybe give me some suggestions on how I could do it. I don't know. It's just like a random idea I had. I did think that maybe I would do it with this video, like I was going to release it with this video in the whole channel when it was all released and stuff like that, but I was like, I don't know, I wasn't quite 100% sure on the idea yet. I don't know, you know, because it's like, because one of the big things I want to do, I do want to definitely involve my comic Cass into this channel a bit more, because like it's my number one drawing project, so I think it's only natural that it be on the drawing channel. Again, someone is moving an entire table around. And I just, oh golly, that's messed up my mind. Oh well, I'm not re-recording this again. I've already done it like 3 times and multiple other things. Oh, fiddlesticks. That's thrown me off my game. What was I saying? Oh yes, the long draw. Okay. So I was thinking maybe I could draw Cass, a page for Cass, you know, that's 10 hours or whatever, and then condense it down to 2 hours, so it's sped up, but not really. I don't know. Because that's the other thing, is like, I couldn't draw for 10 hours and give commentary at the same time. I couldn't. No one, I can't talk for 10 hours straight. I know it might sound like I can, but I really, really can't. I can barely talk for this long without, of course, getting interrupted. You know, but these are just ideas. That I've been pitching. I mean, because of course I'm super excited for this new channel, and I just want to I just want to do everything, you know. I have all these hundreds of ideas that I want to do, and like I want to know what you guys think, so just you guys let me know, you know. Maybe I could, like, what it should be is that I just draw like a small drawing that takes 2 hours or something like that, 1 or 2 hours. Maybe I'll take suggestions even. Maybe I'll do commissions. That's an idea. I've been thinking about doing commissions now that I'll have time, hopefully. After this channel is released and all that, but we'll see, and that'll be the thing, like, just a quick commission that takes about an hour, and I can do live commentary. I can definitely talk for an hour. I can talk for, like, I want to say 5 hours is probably my record for talking, and not stopping, really, maybe, recording, I don't know, we have long aim sessions, but yeah, so please let me know. So yeah, one of the things I was also really excited about is that I haven't done a speed drawing in a while, and a lot of my techniques and stuff have changed and improved. You can see that I'm using a lot more the paintbrush tool and the spray can tool and stuff like that, and I'm doing different effects there. I'm actually really, really happy about how this room ended up, like, and experimenting with all of this. You know, that kind of fade effects that I've got going on there. I call it fade effect. It's not actually what it's called. I'm just amateurish, apparently. And I'm doing them in multiple layers and stuff like that. But yeah, so I'm actually really, really happy with this drawing as well. I didn't even say how I thought about the drawing. I was incredibly happy with it, considering that the subject matter isn't exactly the best in the world. But it's such a non consequential drawing that it's like, I don't know, I just had fun with it. But anyway, if you guys want to know exactly why I made this piece and what the deal with it is, well, I'll let you hear.
Transmodification Central! Can you feel it? You're changing, alright. I hope you're satisfied. But if you ain't, don't blame me. You can blame my friend on the earth.